There is a chat message. We'll just look at that first. He's saying that, can you please give us your views on equal opportunity policy for persons with disability as per section 21? You are on mute, Jaina.
So one issue is this, that the equal opportunity policy. Now see, we have this equal opportunity policy in section 21. Every establishment shall notify an equal opportunity policy detailing measures to be taken in pursuance of this chapter, and this policy will be sent also to the chief commissioner. Now this is basically really not being done too much. This says every establishment, so actually it includes both government and private. We see that some private establishments are doing it, but not all, not many people are aware of it. But government establishments, not, I don't think people are, the government authorities are doing it at all. So that is a big issue, and we are slowly, I think we all have to push to say that this equal opportunity policy has to be framed, because what is important under these policies is that once the policy is framed, it talks about a grievance redressal mechanism. They have to have a grievance and a complaint mechanism so that persons with disabilities can actually file complaints, and then there has to be a redressal of those complaints. There is one more message in the chat that in some organizations, provision of filing a reserve, provision of filling up a reserve post for non-disabled after 2 years is misused. Yes, this happens very frequently. One of the main issues is what they do is they will not advertise the post properly. So often people don't know about it. Then they will not fill up. See, after the first year, जो पहले साल के बाद दूसरे साल में अगर वो डिसेबिलिटी का कोई कैंडिडेट नहीं मिलता है तो दूसरे डिसेबिलिटी से फिल अप कर सकते हैं. तो ऑफन द गवर्नमेंट, वो गवर्नमेंट नहीं करती है, दे डोंट डू इट, एंड देन दे मेक इट लैप्स एंड दे मिसयूज इट, एंड देयरफॉर अ नॉन डिसेबल्ड कैंडिडेट कैन बी फिल्ड इन. सो दिस इज हैपनिंग. एंड वॉट इज द सेफ गार्ड? द सेफ गार्ड इज टू एक्चुअली फॉर ऑल दीज केसेज, द सेफ गार्ड इज रियली टू गो टू कोर्ट. All the cases of employment are, which are going to court, are on all these cases. So we really have to be very, very vigilant, and actually people who are candidates or applicants themselves have to be vigilant to take up some of these cases.
Right. So we'll take questions from our participants now. Nitin, aapne apna hand raise kiya hai. Please unmute kijiye apni taraf se. नितिन, अनम्यूट कर दीजिए और अपना सवाल पूछिए. अगर आपको अनम्यूट करने में टाइम लग रहा है, मैं तब तक फिर दूसरे को पूछ के आपके पास वापस आती हूँ, ठीक है? उस फिर हम टाइम हमारा बचेगा वैसे. हर्षित लोहिया, यू हैव ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड अस इन द चैट.
या ही इज ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड, सो यू ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड.
गुरबख्श, हां जी पूछिए.
मैम, my question is that what are the lacunas in the previous act of 1995, and what is the difference of the, what is the difference in the provisions of this act of 2016 and 1995 RPD act?
So in the previous act, see, reservation related issues are more or less similar. It was 3% and now it is 4%, but in the previous act there was no provision of reasonable accommodation. There was no provision of non-discrimination in employment, equal opportunity policy. All these provisions were not there. So in that way, it is a big advantage. Also, under the previous act, only 7 disabilities were recognized. 40% was there, but only 7 disabilities. Now we have benchmark disabilities at 20, 22, I think. So lot of other disabilities have now come in. Of course, there are many other aspects of transport, sports, education, etc., but I'm really focusing only on employment. So on employment, the whole issue of reasonable accommodation and non-discrimination was not there at all, and that has come. But I feel what is happening is, and of course the number of disabilities, but I feel what is happening now is that the government authorities are still in the mindset of the old act. So the, even though this new provisions of non-discrimination and reasonable accommodation has come, they are not aware of it. Even benchmark disabilities, so many are there. Many people don't get reservation because their particular disability, they are not recognizing, even though it is included in benchmark. And so it is still not being implemented very well, even these different advantageous provisions like non-discrimination and reasonable accommodation.
Okay, Vivek, aap apna sawal puchhiye.
Yes, madam.
Calling, can you listen to me, madam?
Yes.
Actually, I'm myself Vivek Durmane, and I'm working as an assistant section officer in government of NCT of Delhi, Directorate of Education. I wanted to ask the advocate, madam. Madam, actually, what happened is in services department, which is the cadre controlling authority of the Delhi government staff, judge clerical staff. Here in promotion, in ad hoc promotion, they did not give any reservation for the disabled persons. We all submitted our ACR, that is annual confidential report, and also our vigilance clearance in 2018, 19, 20. There they did only ad hoc promotions, but they did not give any reservation. We first filed a complaint to Disabled Commission, Delhi Disabled Commission. They sentenced the order in favor of Delhi government only. Then we had given the case to some one of our visual impaired advocate, but I don't want to disclose anybody's name here. He did not do anything for us for the first 2.5 years. Now they are promoted after 2.5 years. And they are given the seniority from the previous date. From 2018 only, 19 only, they are given the seniority. But now they are telling that the financial benefit will be not given. But the problem is not from our side, madam, not from the disabled person side. The problem is from the department side. But still they are telling no financial benefit will be given. This is a very big loss for us, madam. Can you tell something?
No, this is a serious issue and you must take it up in the court. Because from 2018-19 onwards, they were not giving reservations and promotions. And they were using the excuse of the Siddharaju case being pending in the Supreme Court because the government was trying to deny reservations.
Hello, now unmuted. Hello.
Sorry about that. Yeah.
Hello. Hi, yes, madam. I can listen to you.
I think there is some disturbance. And finally, when the judgment of the Supreme Court came out, they had to give reservation. So now, like you mentioned, in many government departments, they've started giving reservations and promotions. But if they have given you the promotion and if they have given the seniority from that previous date, then from that date, even the salary benefit has to be there, right?
Salary benefit is there, madam. They have fixed the salary from that side. Only salary benefit they are given, but no arrears. No arrears, madam. They told that arrears will be not given for you. But the cited people, normal people, all took their salaries from 2018 and 19. They have monetary benefit, fully monetary benefit. But for disabled persons, no monetary benefits, madam.
No, what they would have done is, in your case, supposing they gave you, when did they give you the promotion?
Just 1 month back, from 14th September 2021.
Basically, they gave it after the Supreme Court decision in the Siddharaju case. Now, if they've given it now, they will now say that we won't give you the arrears and salary because you've not worked. They will say that you have not worked. Because the government didn't give you the promotion and they were delaying it, right? Now this non-payment of arrears is, you can go to court, but it is not very easy, I can say, because...
Yes, madam, we are also planning to go to CAT, madam. Also going to planning to CAT now.
Right, it's not very easy because the court may also say that you have not worked in that post,
But the problem is, madam, the fault is from the department side. We had submitted in 2018, they had demanded our ACR and vigilance clearance. We submitted everything in 2018 also, and we submitted everything in 2019 also. And for cited, they gave ad hoc promotion from 2018. But for our client, they said that there is no provision for disabled in ad hoc promotions.
Yeah. Anyway, it's a good thing that you all are going to the CAT. So please pursue it and see whether you're able to get any relief.
Yes, madam. We are searching for a very good advocate there in CAT. So we'll go there, madam. Okay. Thank you, madam.
Hello.
Thank you.
हेलो मैम.
गैलेक्सी M12 आपका नाम क्या है
मैम? भाग्यलक्ष्मी. भाग्यलक्ष्मी.
भाग्यलक्ष्मी, आपको सवाल पूछना है?
यस मैम. यस मैम.
हाँ पूछिए.
हाँ मैम, हमारा सवाल ये है कि आई एम स्पीकिंग फ्रॉम गुजरात और
या
हाँ जी बताइए.
हाँ मैम, आप हमें सुन रहे हैं? मैम
हाँ हाँ सुन रहे हैं, आप बताइए.
हाँ मैम, आई एम स्पीकिंग फ्रॉम गुजरात. हमारे स्टेट में क्या है, क्लास 1, 2 और 3 में जितने भी डिसेबल के लिए रिजर्व सीट होते हैं, खास करके टोटली ब्लाइंड और लो विजन के लिए, वो आज तक कभी भरे नहीं गए. और उनकी एक पॉलिसी ऐसी थी जिसकी वजह से हमें कभी भी जॉब नहीं दी गई है आज तक. अब उन्होंने थोड़ी उस पॉलिसी को लाइट कर दिया है, लेकिन अभी भी बहुत सारे सवाल है. हमारा केस चल रहा है कोर्ट में, तो उसमें अगर हमारे पास इफ आई कुड गेन 45% ऑफ मार्क्स देन आई एम एलिजिबल फॉर द जॉब. बट वो क्या है कि अभी छुट्टियां हो गई है, तो उसका रिजल्ट जो है वो 15 दिन बाद निकलेगा. बट गवर्नमेंट इज स्टिल डिनाइंग दैट वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड व्हाट एवर यू आर डिमांडिंग फ्रॉम अस. और जो क्लास 3 के लेवल के जो जॉब होते हैं उसमें सभी कैंडिडेट के लिए उन्होंने 40% मार्क्स गेन करने का एक रूल बना रखा है. तो क्या इसे थोड़ा लाइट नहीं बनाया जा सकता, खास करके डिसेबल के लिए?
हाँ, लेकिन नॉन डिसेबल्ड कैंडिडेट्स के लिए क्या परसेंटेज है? 5%.
जी जी. क्लास 3 में उसे बोलते हैं GSSB, उसका फुल फॉर्म अभी हमें याद नहीं आ रहा है. उसमें क्या है, सभी कैंडिडेट्स के लिए 40% मार्क्स गेन करना इम्पोर्टेंट है. अगर आप नहीं करते हैं तो आप लिस्ट से बाहर हो. अगर आप करते हो तो फिर आपका कंप्यूटर टेस्ट होगा, उसके बाद अगर आप मेरिट में आते हो तो आपका सिलेक्शन हो सकता है. लेकिन मैम, उसमें भी आज तक कोई भी ब्लाइंड कैंडिडेट को नहीं लिया गया है. किसी भी मतलब लोकोमोटर को लिया गया है, लेकिन ब्लाइंड कैंडिडेट आपको एक भी नहीं मिलेगा गवर्नमेंट जॉब में, चाहे फिर वो क्लास 1, 2, 3 हो या फिर लोअर क्लास 3 हो, कहीं पर भी नहीं मिलेगा. तो इसके लिए हम लोग बहुत सारी फाइट कर रहे हैं, लेकिन मैम हमें न्याय ही नहीं मिल रहा है इस मसले को लेकर.
नहीं, ये इसका बहुत
और मैम हमारा मैम एक मिनट. हाँ मैम, दूसरा सवाल ये है, 2020 में सुप्रीम कोर्ट कहा था कि डिसेबल आर एलिजिबल फॉर द सेम बेनिफिट्स एज STSC. खास तौर पे ये कहा गया था, उन्होंने कहा था अटेम्प्ट को लेकर, UPSC में जो हमारा अटेम्प्ट है उसे लेकर. लेकिन मैम, ना सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट भी इसे इंप्लीमेंट नहीं कर रही है. हमने बहुत सारे लेटर्स लिखे हैं इस मसले को लेकर, मेल्स भी भेजे सुप्रीम कोर्ट को, HRD को और PWD को, लेकिन उन्होंने कोई जवाब नहीं दिया इस मसले को लेकर. तो इसमें भी हमें कुछ करना चाहिए मैम.
हाँ, तो मैं जस्ट आपके जवाब का रिप्लाई दे रही हूँ. जो पहले इशू के बारे में आपने बोला था कि ये कैटेगरी में ब्लाइंड पर्संस का रिक्रूटमेंट नहीं हो रहा है, ये सचमुच हर स्टेट का प्रॉब्लम है कि ग्रुप ABC में, मतलब जो टॉप जो कैटेगरी के ग्रुप्स हैं उसमें वो लोग ब्लाइंड लो विजन कैंडिडेट्स को नहीं लेते. और ये आपको डेफिनेटली, ये देखिए सेक्शन 33 और 34 में, सेक्शन 34 में क्लियरली एक पोस्ट 1% को ब्लाइंड और लो विजन के लिए रिजर्व रखना ही है. तो अगर उन्होंने नहीं लिया है तो किस वजह से नहीं लिया है? आपको एक्चुअली ये इशू को कोर्ट ले जाना चाहिए, कोई भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन या आपके नाम या दूसरे कोई पेटिशनर के नाम. और आप एक काम कर सकते हैं, RTI एप्लीकेशन बना सकते हैं कि हाउ मेनी पीपल आर अपॉइंटेड इन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन दीज पोस्ट हु आर ब्लाइंड और लो विजन, वो भी आप देख सकते हैं. और अगर ये टेस्ट जो आप 40% बोल रहे हैं, जो रेगुलर नॉन डिसेबल्ड कैंडिडेट्स के लिए 40% है, तो इसमें डेफिनेटली आप रिलैक्सेशन मांग सकते हैं कि फॉर डिसेबल्ड या ब्लाइंड कैंडिडेट्स आप थोड़ा रिलैक्स कीजिए, 35 मार्क्स बना दीजिए. दूसरे एससी एसटी कैंडिडेट्स के लिए हमेशा कुछ कंसेशन तो होता ही है, तो आई कैन सजेस्ट दैट.
यस मैम.
हेलो मैम.
गुरप्रीत.
हेलो.
हाँ जी.
हाँ जी. यस मैम. मेरा आई वांट टू आस्क सम क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली.
हाँ जी.
आई एम वर्किंग इन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ एनसीटी ऑफ दिल्ली एज अ पर्सनल असिस्टेंट एंड हियर वी आई एम वर्किंग एज अ स्टेनोग्राफर देयर. मींस पर्सनल असिस्टेंट मींस स्टेनोग्राफर क्रेडर. सो व्हाट्स द प्रॉब्लम इज देयर. First, they have identified our post for reservation in promotion. It was first identified, but in उन्होंने cadre restructure किया and they turned it into group B post and they stopped giving reservation in promotion in that cadre. Now we all are promoted in general categories. No reservation is there for stenographer cadre in Delhi government. First thing. And second thing, when this matter was brought to the Disability Commission, it came out that there is no roster at all. Means no disabled. Actually, we are giving promotion 3% promotion. They have kept giving. They are saying that we have kept this provision of 3% for disabled persons, but we have not prepared any reservation roster. So they are not giving it actually as per rules. For any person, like in even in other cadres also, they are just promoting on their own, but not as per the guidelines issued by the government of India, and as per DOPT order 29th December 2005. So as a result, we are all are getting promotion. I have got the promotion after 16 years in general category. Whereas initially this promotion was being given after 6 years, people were promoted after 6 years. Now this matter was also taken up with the Disability Commission, and this and he said you should make the roster first, disability roster. But they haven't done anything after that. So Disability Commission said it's only the recommendations we can give. We can't do any further. So what's the remedy, ma'am, in this case?
No, I mean, see, these are very common issues where when you actually push the issue of reservation, you realize that they don't have a roster and they are not maintaining the roster. And then that is why they cannot even do the reservation properly. So the first thing is demanding the roster, then they can't change the cadre just like that where they don't give reservations. And many of these things actually Commissioner for Disability cannot do. So you will have to go to the High Court.
Ma'am, one thing is
or the Administrative Tribunal, you'll have to go to the High Court or the Tribunal, because Commissioner of Disability, they may tell the government to...
Studied all the documents and every document, see, they given something, this that we have done this, and there are many anomalies they found, like non-selection post five times the zone, like these types of this they found there, but they haven't done anything in the action taken report which they submitted. They just gave it and nothing was done.
No, you'll have to go to the High Court.
And
because
secondly,
ultimately the commissioner does not have the powers to enforce the directions, you know.
Okay. And ma'am, can I have your help in this regard for this?
What we'll do is I can ask either Shabnam or Mr. George to send you my email and contact details.
You
can write to me separately. If depending on what has to be done, if I can assist, I'll let you know.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. And also, they have stopped identifying this stenographer post from this promotion. Malab reservation in promotion, they are not giving at all. First, they were giving as a group C post. they says they are now it is converted into group B, and that was also wrong. Actually, in DOPT order, they have said even if the one grade it is converted to another grade, if there is a post identified, then also the same provisions will be given. It's not that they will finish the reservation, and if they want to do it, also they have should have taken some. It's like proper procedure should be adopted. Nothing and that sort of have been done.
Yeah, all these things will have to be challenged.
So yeah. my request, Gurpreet, my request is that when you write, when we'll connect you with ma'am, so you can list out the various issues that need to be addressed.
I can provide documents also regarding this. Sir, please you provide me all those details later.
Yes, sure. We'll get in touch.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah. Hello, madam.
Ma'am.
Hello.
One minute at a time.
Nitin, aap sawal puchhe hai bahut time se koshish.
Hello, madam. Hamara sawal legal process related hai.
Haan ji, bataiye.
Hello.
Haan ji, puchhe. Aapki awaaz aa rahi hai. Puchhe.
Haan ji, ye mere mother, brother aur father ki अप्रैल में सेकेंड वेव में ऑक्सीजन की कमी से डेथ हो गई थी, तब जैसे बैंक में एफडी अमाउंट क्लेम करना है तो उसके लिए सर्वाइविंग मेंबर सर्टिफिकेट चाहिए सक्सेशन?
वो तो जहां आप हैं वहां बताएंगे कि सक्सेशन सर्टिफिकेट चाहिए या सर्वाइविंग मेंबर्स का, उन्हीं को पूछना पड़ेगा।
अच्छा जी, वैसे सक्सेशन और सर्वाइविंग में फर्क क्या होता है?
सक्सेशन सर्टिफिकेट तो कोर्ट से लेना पड़ेगा,
कहीं में जाना ना
जब जरूरत पड़ती है।
सर्टिफिकेट तो पर जस्ट तहसीलदार या किसी और से भी हो सकता है, क्योंकि हर जगह में उनका टर्मिनोलॉजी अलग होता है। यहाँ में फॉर एग्जांपल सर्वाइविंग सर्टिफिकेट नहीं होता है, सिर्फ फैमिली ट्री बोल सकते हैं कि हमारा आपका फैमिली ट्री दीजिए।
जैसे अभी मैं और मेरी बहन है तो हम क्लेम कर सकते हैं, तो सक्सेशन चाहिए सर्वाइविंग मेंबर?
नहीं, आपको क्या क्लेम करना है?
एफडी अमाउंट बैंक में जो पैसे उनका अमाउंट क्लेम करने
आपको उस ऑफिस में क्या सर्टिफिकेट
एफडी अमाउंट से,
तो वहीं आप वहां पूछिए
ठीक है
क्या सर्टिफिकेट उनको चाहिए।
ठीक है, ठीक।
हेलो मैम,
भाग्यलक्ष्मी आपको सवाल फिर से पूछ रहे हैं कुछ?
यस मैम, एक सवाल बाकी रह गया था।
पूछिए।
हाँ मैम, सवाल ये है, एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर, 2020 में सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा था डिसेबल आर एलिजिबल फॉर द सेम बेनिफिट्स एज एसटी एससी एंड ओबीसी, तो इसे इम्प्लीमेंट करवाने के लिए हम लोग क्या क्या कर सकते हैं? और मैम हमारी गुजारिश है अगर कुछ कर सकते हैं तो आप ही करें, क्योंकि आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट में प्रैक्टिस करती है, तो यू हैव द वेज टू मेक इट इम्प्लीमेंट।
ये पूरा इतना सारा नहीं मैं ले सकती, नो, बट व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज के ब्लैंकेट एससी एसटी को जो बेनिफिट्स मिल रहा है वो डिसेबल को मिलना चाहिए। एक्चुअली वो जजमेंट में जजमेंट का मतलब ये नहीं है कि जो भी एससी एसटी को बेनिफिट मिल रहा है वही डिसेबल्ड पर्संस को भी मिले, वो जजमेंट का वो मतलब नहीं है। लेकिन वो जजमेंट लेके हमें क्या इम्प्लीमेंट करना है, वो स्पेसिफिक जो प्रेयर है वो बना के हम लोग पेटिशन के लिए डिस्कस कर सकते हैं।
यस मैम। मैम
लक्ष्मी, अभी और भी सवाल है बहुत सारे लोगों के, तो
आप एक आखिरी सवाल मैम, हम ये कहना चाहते हैं अगर आप हमें ईमेल और अपनी कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल भेज दे तो हम सारा इशू जो है वो आपको लिख कर भेज देंगे।
हाँ, मेरा ईमेल आईडी आपको शेयर करेंगे,
ऑलरेडी चैट में किया हुआ है,
और आप ईमेल कर सकते हैं मुझे।
यस मैम, चैट से तो हमें पता नहीं चलेगा, कृपया आप हमें मेल कर दीजिएगा।
ठीक है भाग्यलक्ष्मी, हम आपको कर देंगे।
थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू।
जयचंद्रन प्लीज अपना सवाल पूछिए, आप म्यूट पे है, अनम्यूट कीजिए। हाँ जी,
हेलो।
हाँ जी,
मैडम, हु इज द अपेलेट अथॉरिटी फॉर सीसीपीडी मैडम? एक्चुअली
अपेलेट अथॉरिटी फॉर
सीसीपीडी,
CCPD, I don't know. CCPD is what?
Chief Commissioner. There is no appellate. There is the State Commissioner and Chief Commissioner.
After that, you just have to go to the High Court. There is no appellate authority.
Okay. Okay, madam. High Court means for our case, we need to search for a disabled activist advocate or what actually, madam? Normally,
no,
if
you go... can search for any advocate. Wherever you are, where are you based?
Chennai.
Look for an advocate in Chennai to take up your matters. If you want, we have from our Center for Law and Policy Research, we have an advocate there. His name is Prabhu. We can give you a reference, and my colleague Ritambara can give contact details, and you can contact the advocate there who does a lot of disability work.
Shall I contact George sir in this regard?
You connect with me and I will connect you with
Prabhu.
We'll do the connection. We'll do the connection.
Madam, what is your organization name you told me?
Center for Law and Policy Research.
Center for Law and Policy Research. Okay. Yes. Thank you, madam.
Siddhappa Galaxy. आप अपना सवाल पूछिए, अनम्यूट कीजिए अपने okay, संदीप कुमार आप सवाल पूछिए अपना।
हेलो हेलो बेटा,
संदीप जी अपना सवाल पूछिए।
मैम आई वांट टू आस्क यू my handicap certificate of 100%, but I
आपके यहाँ बहुत शोर है संदीप, आप सुनाई नहीं दे रहे बिल्कुल भी। हाँ जी बताइए
मैम।
हाँ जी
मैम, my handicap certificate of 100%, but and I can see little bit 25%, so I ask you, so I can't apply government job of low vision category, in low vision category?
No, you can't apply, because see, if your certificate shows 100% and you apply for low vision, they will not take you because your certificate is showing 100%. If you can see up to 25%, then you redo your certificate.
Yes, ma'am. But ma'am, I can see 25% little
bit. Yes, but your certificate is different, sir.
Okay.
You will not get under, you can get under blind category, blind or low vision. If it is a common thing, you can get. But if some post is only for low vision, then they may not give you because your certificate is not matching. You know?
Yes, ma'am.
Then you may have to redo your certificate.
Okay. Thank you, Sandeep. Siddhappa, can you unmute yourself? Or ma'am, ma'am. You yes.
Ma'am, namaskar.
Namaskar, yes. Puchhiye sawal.
Ma'am. I'm from Karnataka.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm working as a second divisional assistant in a court, civil court.
Hmm.
But when I joined my duty, till now I didn't get any software, work environment. These are all things. I'm tried to convince with computer also. I will do, these are all things I know about computers, all the things I put laptop and I want to do demo with all that stuff. They are not able to listen about my problem to working do for work environment, creating work environment. For this solution, what we can do?
You write a letter to the principal judge,
ma'am,
and also to the Chief Justice of the Karnataka High Court. Why don't you do that? That I want all these facilities. These are provisions of reasonable accommodation. Kindly provide me. If the principal judge is not giving it to you, that copy you also send to Chief Justice and say that I have also made all these representations. You please put that in writing.
What my problem is, If we directly cannot able to write a letter from low level court to high court, these are all things they will say, you have to write proper through proper channel. if I try to write a letter, many letters in district court, they are not even forwarded to district courts also. Many more applications are written.
Have you sent a letter to your principal judge of the district court? Have you sent a letter there?
Yes, ma'am.
Has it been received by the principal judge of the district
court?
They didn't give any reply for those applications. No, doesn't matter. You have given your letter, right? You have got an acknowledgement. Has the letter been given to the principal judge?
Or it has not yet reached
there, it is somewhere in the way.
Siddhappa, have you got any proof? Do you have any proof that you have given a letter to the principal judge?
I have an office copy with me.
Which is signed by the judge's office?
Yes, sir.
Okay, he's got the acknowledgement.
Okay. Then if the, why don't you go and meet the principal judge?
I tried many times, but they will listen. But this has to come from High Court. We are not able to do anything.
Then you say, write this, a letter like to that. The Chief Justice of the Karnataka High Court with a copy of this principal judge's letter that you gave. You say, I have made many requests, but I've met them also, but nobody's providing this. I'm giving you a copy of the letter I have sent. Why don't you write to the Chief Justice? And after all that, if they still don't do, we may have to do some other strategy. But at least you write to the Chief Justice, what is there, with a copy of your previous letters.
We don't have power that write to Chief Justice, but I met district level.
What is their power, sir? Send a letter by post, by registered post.
If they will know, they will many persons tried once, they will issue notice for us. That's why it is some problem. Okay.
Why don't you ask now, okay.
Now we are doing something. We convinced in High Court level, the technical department with we are coordinating. And we took that from RTI, who are all working blind persons in court department. Then we are enclosing, and we are doing some working environment that who will prepare that CIS manual. For them, we are sending letters, and we met once five judges in High Court. These are all some little bit progressing, ma'am.
You have to keep trying to do that. Veer Kyataya and all of them.
These are all Karnataka Government Blind Employees Association. Through these, we are doing this.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
But it's interesting that. The arm of the law themselves are kind of violating the
the law, the judges and lawyers and legal profession is only not providing legal reasonable accommodation. In fact, the biggest thing is they are not even excluding in from the civil judge's post. So the biggest the law thinks that it is not touchable, you know, and the ones who make the law will not implement the law.
Absolutely. It's quite an ironical situation.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Chandra Prakash, please ask your question. Unmute kijiye khud ko. Sharad, we'll come to you. Chandra Prakash ne apna haath pehle se raise kiya hai.
Haan ji, madam, mera ek thoda sa critical point hai thoda. Hello? Awaaz aa rahi hai meri?
Boliye. Haan ji, aa rahi hai. Aap poochiye.
Madam, मैं 90% विजन डिसेबल पर्सन हूं और मैं प्राइवेट कंपनी डीएलएफ ग्रुप में काम कर रहा था. हेलो, आवाज आ रही है मैडम?
हाँ जी, आप पूछिए.
तो इसमें क्या है, मेरे को मैं काम करते 28 साल हो गए. अभी लॉकडाउन में यानी 4 जून 2021 को इन्होंने सडनली टर्मिनेशन लेटर दे दिया मेरे को. इससे पहले मैंने सीसीपीडी में केस डाला था, मैं केस जीत भी गया था एक साल पहले, यानी कि जुलाई 2020 में उन्होंने रिकमेंडेशन किया था कि डिसेबिलिटी एक्ट है 2016 उसके अकॉर्डिंग इनको रखो और केयर करो. तो इन्होंने इसका वायोलेट भी कर दिया और टर्मिनेट भी दे दिया. उसके बाद फिर दोबारा मैंने इनको फाइल दी सीसीपीटी को कि भाई इनको टर्मिनेट क्यों किया। उन्होंने कल हियरिंग भी थी तो केस हमारा तो सुना नहीं उन्होंने, हमारा तो बहुत कम दी, कुछ बातें सुनी सारी उनकी कंपनी के फेवर में दे दिया, अननेसेसरी यानी कि इलीगली कर दिया, क्या कैसे कर दिया पता नहीं, क्योंकि 90% विजुअल डिसेबल्ड पर्सन है। अब इस केस में क्या करें, अब हाई कोर्ट जाना चाहिए हमको, क्या करें?
देखिए हर केस में पेपर्स और सब देखे बिना मुश्किल होता है कुछ एडवाइस देना, लेकिन अगर कुछ डिसीजन आपके अगेंस्ट है तो फिर हाई कोर्ट ही जाना पड़ेगा, लेकिन आपके पेपर्स और सब डिसीजन
मैं आपको भेज देता हूँ, मुझे बताओ।
नहीं नहीं आप मुझे मत भेजिए, आप कहाँ हैं? मैं तो हर जगह
में हूँ।
हाँ तो आप
You know, one sec. This employer is a private player.
Private.
DLF is it's a private builder.
तो फिर high court नहीं, तो फिर आपको civil court या कुछ देखना पड़ेगा, तो फिर high court नहीं जा सकते हैं, तो आपको गुड़गांव में ही कोई local advocate.
नहीं मैडम, actually क्या है, ये equal to civil court है ना, CCPD court.
नहीं नहीं equal to civil court नहीं है सर।
नहीं है, चीफ कमिश्नर ऑफ पर्सन ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी।
नहीं 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 नहीं, आपको कोई एडवोकेट वहाँ गुड़गांव में आप ढूंढिए, वो आपके सब पेपर्स देख के फिर सिविल कोर्ट या कहाँ जाएंगे वो देख के।
नहीं उन्होंने एडवाइस किया था, सीसीपीटी ने भी एडवाइस किया कि आप हाई कोर्ट जाओ और लॉयर ने भी एडवाइस किया कि आप हाई कोर्ट जाओ।
ठीक है, तो एनीवे आपके पेपर्स सब देखने पड़ेंगे, मैं हाई कोर्ट में कोई लोकल लॉयर है तो ही मैं अपीयर करती हूँ, तो बेटर आप दिल्ली में कोई एडवोकेट ढूंढिए, जो दिल्ली भी नहीं आप गुड़गांव में है तो फिर कौन सी हाई कोर्ट होगी वहां।
दिल्ली से ही मैंने लॉयर से बात की है, दिल्ली में ही।
ठीक है, तो आप तो ऑलरेडी लॉयर से बात की है ना।
किससे?
लॉयर से,
दिल्ली लॉयर में बात की है मैंने। एक्चुअली कोई डिसेबिलिटी केस को करने वाला कोई लॉयर हो तो आप बता दीजिए, मैं रिकमेंड कर दीजिए।
नहीं दिल्ली में तो बहुत है।
नहीं जो आपकी नॉलेज में हो, मेरी नॉलेज में तो है नहीं, क्योंकि डिसेबल।
आप इनसे बात कीजिए, राजन मणि से।
राजन मणि, इनका नंबर वगैरह है कोई? मैडम
राजन मणि आपको उनका ईमेल आईडी और सब मिल जाएगा।
किसके थ्रू मिलेगा मैडम?
ऑनलाइन आप ढूंढिए, आप राजन मणि का मिल जाएगा। राजन मणि बहुत डिसेबिलिटी मैटर्स कर रहे हैं, या आई एम श्योर शबनम और मिस्टर जॉर्ज आपको दे सकते हैं।
अच्छा, तो हाई कोर्ट
में आपका नाम मिला। हाँ जी, हम आपको फोन करते हैं, हमें हमारे पास आपका नंबर होगा।
ठीक है,
हाँ तो हम ये ऑफलाइन ले लेते हैं आपके साथ। हर्षित, सॉरी हर्षित, आई विल कम टू यू। शरद, आप कुछ सवाल पूछना चाहते थे?
यस यस, दिस इज शरद त्रिपाठी फ्रॉम जयपुर।
जी
तो नमस्ते टू ऑल, जोर से नमस्ते। तो विषय आप सुन पा रहे ना मुझे?
हाँ जी शरद जी बोलिए।
जी जी जी, तो विषय बहुत सारा है और बहुत ही अच्छा सेशन आज का रहा, तो इसमें मैं अब इतना सा शेयर करना चाहता हूँ कि ये सारा जो हो रहा है, तो इस किसी चीज के लिए मैं भी लगभग 7 years से सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट में काम कर रहा था, डिपार्टमेंट में काम किया अलग अलग एग्जाम्स थ्रू जाके वहां पर। तो अभी नेहरू युवा केंद्र में लास्ट अपनी थी, मेरी सर्विसेस को टर्मिनेट कर दिया गया कन्फर्मेशन होने से पहले, प्रोविजन का पूरा होने के बाद कंफर्मेशन होने से पहले। और इश्यूज थे एक्सेसिबिलिटी के इश्यूज और रीजनेबल अकोमोडेशन, इन सब के लिए मैं लगातार लिख रहा था डिपार्टमेंट को, और उससे इतने रिलेशंस खराब हो गए उन सारी चीजों से। जो एक्टिविज्म हम बाहर करते थे वो डिपार्टमेंट में जब किया तो उससे बहुत सारा इश्यूज हो गया, और सिर्फ इतना सा था कि एक्टिविज्म करते समय कुछ रास्ते जाम और इस तरह की चीजों के कुछ FIRs मेरे अगेंस्ट में पहले दर्ज थे, और वो सरकार ने फिर उनको विड्रॉ भी कर लिया था, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ राजस्थान ने, जब मैंने होम सेक्रेटरी और सीएम से रिक्वेस्ट किया तो वो सारे केसेस विड्रॉ हो गए। लेकिन हुआ ये कि लोकल पुलिस स्टेशन ने अपने केसेस को अपडेट नहीं किया, मेरी FIRs को, कि भी इनके केसेस विड्रॉ हो चुके हैं और डिस्पोज हो चुके हैं कोर्ट से, लेकिन वो अपडेट नहीं था उनका रिकॉर्ड। और जब नेहरू युवा केंद्र ने मेरा पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन मार्क मंगाया तो प्रोबेशन कंप्लीट होने के बाद, तो वो पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन नेगेटिव गया, और उसमें दो केसेस रिपोर्ट किए गए कि इन दो केसेस के कोर्ट में चल रहे हैं, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं था, केसेस डिस्पोज हो चुके थे। और चूंकि एक केस ऐसा था जिसमें बहुत सारे लोग चार्जशीटेड थे, तो मुझे अपडेट भी नहीं था उसको। जब मैंने नेहरू युवा केंद्र ज्वाइन किया तो उसके बारे में मैंने उस पर डिक्लेरेशन में नहीं डाला था। हालांकि मैंने फ्रेश डिक्लेरेशन नेहरू युवा केंद्र को नहीं दिया था, बिकॉज आई वॉज ऑलरेडी सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय। तो मेरा पुराने डिपार्टमेंट का जो विजिलेंस रिपोर्ट था उसी के बेसिस पे मैंने ज्वाइन किया था। अब इस तरह का क्रिटिकल केस में मैं उलझ गया हूँ, तो हालांकि मुझे लीगल एडवाइस तो आप जो समझ आपकी बनती है इस शॉर्ट नरेशन से वो आप बताइएगा। बाकी मैं सभी साथियों को शेयर करना चाहूंगा कि ये हालात बहुत गंभीर हैं और रीजनेबल अकोमोडेशन कहीं पर भी नहीं है। मैंने 4 से 5 डिपार्टमेंट ट्राई किए, और या तो आप काम ना करें, चुपचाप बैठे रहें, देखते रहें अपनी टेबल की तरफ और अपने मोबाइल की तरफ, और या फिर कुछ करने का कोशिश करेंगे तो इस तरह के सारे चैलेंजेस और डिफिकल्टीज आपके सामने पेश आएंगी। खैर, ट्रांसफर पोस्टिंग का तो सिनेरियो बहुत ही खराब है, और जिस डिपार्टमेंट में अभी मैं था लास्ट, जहाँ से मेरा टर्मिनेशन हुआ है, वहाँ तो और भी डिफिकल्ट है। तो ये सारी चीजें हैं। जॉर्ज सर, हम सब लोग मिलकर जो भी आज बातचीत आपने की है उसके लिए बहुत सारी शुभकामनाएं और शुक्रिया, और थैंक यू टू ऑल।
I think what he has highlighted are the real issues, you know. Of course, his case is quite complicated, so I cannot advise or say anything on that. But आपने ठीक से बताया है कि reasonable accommodation कहीं भी नहीं मिल रहा है। वो सिद्धप्पा भी जो बोल रहे थे कि उनको कुछ काम नहीं कर सकते हैं, तो just बैठ के टेबल पे देखना है या फ़ोन पे देखना है, यूज़ करना है, और कुछ काम करने की आप कोशिश करते हैं या रीज़नेबल अकोमोडेशन मांगते हैं तो बहुत मुश्किल होती है। तो दैट इज़ अ रियलिटी, एंड हाउ डू वी एड्रेस दीज इश्यूज़ विद इन द गवर्नमेंट, आई थिंक एटलीस्ट एज ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस वी ऑल हैव टू रियली वर्क ऑन।
इट्स अ मेसी प्लेस, इज़न्ट इट, द होल थिंग।
Yeah.
Any more questions, Shabna?
Yeah, Harshit, please, apna, can you ask your question? Harshit, please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, I have posted my question in the chat box regarding the internet banking websites of many banks are not accessible and they are not WCAG compliant. So instead of following up with individual banks, can't we take up a PIL against all the scheduled banks that they should submit an accessibility report, audit report to the court?
Yes, I think it's very important. And not just internet banking websites for internet banking. Of course, internet banking is a important aspect. I mean, it's a non-negotiable aspect now if we have to use any services. But many other websites of other, services and goods and internet, where you can, even things like Amazon, Flipkart, etc. I don't know whether they are accessible or not, but definitely banks, yes, that they are not compliant, and we must think of filing a PIL. I totally agree.
My opinion is that instead of falling with individual institutions, any company, any organization, which is being funded by taxpayers' money, should submit their audit report, accessibility
yes,
audit
agree.
Report.
I agree. In fact, about 3-4 years back, when this, when the 2016 Act was enacted, actually 2-3 organizations had approached me, and we were thinking of filing a PIL that, including banks and all other websites, should submit their audit report and be accessible. Then I think it just didn't happen, but I think we should take it up.
One example that the largest bank of the country, State Bank of India's internet banking portal, still contains an audio capture. I have written to the customer service team multiple times, but no response has been there. The UNO portal
the bank,
still contains
an audio capture.
Image capture, sorry.
These are problems which have been constantly being, in fact, challenged in the court, constantly being written about. There are people who take some steps, and then when there are upgrades happening, the inaccessibility again comes in as an issue. I wanted to ask
sir,
you.
Judge sir, 1 minute. Sir, something regarding SBI, Mr. Onusampa, he said, actually, may I know more about that?
Yeah.
Because our internet banking is completely accessible, no issues at all.
this is meaning you are talking about what about
SBA, the SBA.
I'm also an ex-state banker. I've resigned from SBI last year only. The old portal of SBI, which is onlinesbi.com, is accessible. But the modern portal, which is Yono portal, it is completely inaccessible.
Yeah, you are right. That is right. But you are right. That is right, actually. But internet banking is completely accessible. We have audio capture as well. That is the thing. Okay.
That is all,
I know that. Yono is not accessible. That I agree. Okay. Yeah, okay. Thanks a lot, George.
All the services which are offered on Yono are not there on online SBI.
Yeah. Okay. I think this is an issue. I think, I think a lot of banks, a lot of government websites, I think we have problems. What I wanted to ask you, Jaina, was that I was reading about structured negotiation as an approach to addressing some of these disability access issues. Meaning this is where the different stakeholders come around the table, and because very often the issues are unresolved because the service providers don't really understand or appreciate the situation, and therefore, they don't take it seriously. But, Mini, are you aware of this structured negotiation kind of approach?
I'm aware of it, but I'm not sure whether it is being practiced or to what extent it is being used or being successful. So, for example, whether you have tried it, because I mean, you know, how do the challenge is that where one party which is in power, like your government authority, is totally closed and not interested and not aware of all these issues, and say the some employees or some organizations or a few other experts go, are they open to having these structured conversations or negotiations, and how do you take that forward? Forward, or what has your experience been?
Well, I don't have any direct experience on this. I actually started thinking about this because I do a podcast called IWAY Conversations, and I've just had a conversation with an American disability activist called Leni Feingold, and she at length spoke about this structured. Maybe it may not be something that we could deal with the government, but we could probably look at these banks and so on, start from there and kind of build a case for it, and maybe that could be a starting point. But the current topic, which is employment in the government, I guess you're right, the government is closed, difficult to access, and we don't know which is the central. I mean, there's no real central authority that can make a decision apart from maybe the Prime Minister or Amit Shah. So I think we are...
It all depends on... But that doesn't mean we should not think of these different options, because ultimately it all depends on where somebody, at least in the organization, has a willingness or an openness and the power to do something, then there is an opening, and that is really the challenge, in the government.
Right. Shabnam, are we done with all the questions? Or,
yes, we're done with questions. There are no other hands raised.
George, sir, actually, you are talking about the structured negotation.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm Gopri. I think there are provisions like this reasonable accommodation. There is one DOPT order that you should provide computers and all those to blind people. And it's very lengthy order. I have read once long ago. So, but it is not implemented. What I think that NGOs can help in this, like they can ask for that, how many people are provided with computers in government? Because like as an employee, when we go and I have done as a full-time, means I have done I have worked as a stenographer in court. And they are also means in consumer court, not in very big court. So there I have been doing all the work, all taking dictations, taking orders, everything I did. So they have accommodated means like I said I will do it on this screen reading software. So I use the cracked version because there is no other option at that time. So I took this crack version from this NAB India, and yeah. there I did it. Means they approved my that I can do this taking dictations on shorthand machine and all that. So it's also that there I do, but now in present office, I'm now in education. So yeah. they are saying that what will you do? Other people are not even doing, sighted people are not even doing. But there I am doing now different type of work. I'm not sitting, I'm doing like, I'm helping two colleagues. We are doing in teamwork, like they're helping them with noting and drafting over there. And means they are reading me files, but that is not the right way actually. They are not giving me access to the computer. Right. There also I installed one cracked version of JAWS, but that never, they don't give me that access to that computer. They say, you just tell us, we will read it to you, like that. Sort of thing. So here I what I feel NGOs can come forward and ask these people, because we at our level, if we struggle with these issues now on our own, they will then start creating problem for us also. Like they will give us the work and they will just go away. They say, you can do, you are saying like that, things can happen to us. I that's what I feel. So there means ek jaise ikatthe hokar ek work hone mein isme zarurat hai jo negotiations hai na routine negotiations with higher authorities ki how many people are being provided with computers, are they working properly, that audio should be also there actually,
right?
Should be hum kya hai, hum dikhte hain, hum wahan work karte ho hi nahi nazar aate, log sochte hain blind work hi nahi kar sakta, to hum work karte ho nazar aayenge to वो एक राइट मैसेज जाता है सोसाइटी को, जस्ट इन गेटिंग प्रमोशन एंड जॉब्स में मिल गया और उसके बाद हम वहां जाके बैठ गए तो उसका भी कोई फायदा नहीं, अपने लिए भी फायदा नहीं, उनके लिए भी फायदा नहीं, सोसाइटी के लिए भी फायदा नहीं।
या आई थिंक दिस इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग प्रोपोजिशन, हम लोग ऑफलाइन इस पे बारे में बात करते हैं एंड वी विल कनेक्ट विद यू मे बी आफ्टर दिवाली एंड देन वी कैन टॉक मोर अबाउट दिस।
या या
ओके या थैंक यू गुरप्रीत।
ओके
So now that all questions are done, Jaina, let me formally say shukriya, dhanyavad, thank you. And you've given us precious information that I think given us an understanding of what is available. Of course, a lot is available, but is as good as not being available because of the lack of implementation. But I think you know, we feel refreshed and maybe you know, some fight can be kind of taken on from here. So thank you very much, Jaina, and I'll connect with you the next time I'm in Bangalore. Yeah
thank you George, thank you Shabnam, thank you for inviting me. I enjoyed the session. Thank you.